Kadapa was a part of Hiranyarashtra in ancient times. Kadapa, also known as Gadapa, means threshold. It is the gateway of Tirumala and Tirupati. Since time immemorial, the pilgrims were halting at Kadapa, worshipped Sri Lakshmi Venkateswara Swami here, and were proceeding to Tirumala, the abode of Lord Venkateswara. Writing about Kadapa district, Colonel Wilkes, a British historian, says, "Each stream in this part of the country has its song to sing and every hill its story to narrate. But unfortunately, they do not narrate them, or if they do it in the language unintelligible to the modern historians." In other words, Kadapa district has a hoary past. It is full of rich historical antiquities. Many Sthala Puranas, local legends and oral traditions are associated with the monuments. They are of a special interest to the pilgrims, tourists and historians. Let us have a look at the historical, religious and cultural importance of the places and persons. Let us discover the heritage of Kadapa. The prehistoric rock paintings found at Chintakunta Caves near Muddanur are said to be the second largest group of paintings in India after Bhimbetika rock paintings. The rock paintings with mystic figures are also found at Dappalle village near Mailavaram Dam in Jammalamadugu Taluk. Vellala means "I have to go." These are the words of Sri Anjaneya. The preceding deity is called Sanjeeva Raya, as he brought Sanjeevani, a medical herb, to bring Lakshmana back to life during the Rama Ravana conflict. Pruddutur derived its name from Pruddu, which means sunrise, and Uru means village. Pruddutur is well known for its temple of Mukti Ramalingeshwara on the banks of the Penna River. It is said to have been built by Sri Rama on his return journey from Lanka. The story of this temple is as follows. Rama received a divine intimation that he would be relieved of the sin of killing Ravana if he constructed two Shiva temples. He erected one at the famous Rameshwaram in Tamil Nadu and another one here. When this temple was under construction, Rama sent Hanuman to Benares to get a Shivalinga. As Hanuman did not return within the time fixed for the Pratishtha, Rama made a Shivalinga out of sand and installed it. This Shivalinga was miraculously converted into a stone, but it still bears the marks of Rama's fingers. The Agastheshwara temple at Pruddutur is said to have been consecrated by sage Agastya. Sri Kanaka Parameshwari temple is the 125-year-old temple and is also the richest temple in the district. Gandhi is also known as Vayu Kshetra. According to a legend, Rama visited Gandhi on his return journey from Lanka. Vayu, the father of Anjaneya, hung a golden torana, a wreath of golden flowers, across the ravine and welcomed Rama. Before leaving the place, Rama carved the figure of Anjaneya on a rock. Ontimitta is also known as Ekasila Nagaram because the idols of Rama, Lakshmana and Sita are made of a single stone. It was installed by Jambavanta. It is the only temple in India without Anjaneya. This is the peculiarity of this temple. Tavernier, the French traveler who visited the place in 1652, described the temple as one of the grandest pagodas in the whole of India. Jainism had enough patronage in Kadapa district. The remains of the Jaina temple are found at Danavalapadu on the banks of Penna River. Buddhism flourished in Kadapa district for many years along the banks of Cheyyeru and Penna rivers. Nandalur, Tallapaka, Rajampeta, Kunduru and Kajipeta are the important Buddhist sites in Kadapa district. The Roman gold coins were discovered at Attirala in 1838. This clearly establishes trade links between Kadapa and Roman Empire. The first Telugu inscription was discovered at Kallamalla. It was issued by Renati Cholas in the 6th century AD. Sri Lakshmi Venkateswara Swami is the presiding deity of the temple. The god is referred to as Kadapa Raya in the Telugu inscription dated 1552, and it is found on the walls of the temple. Sri Kodanda Ramaswamy temple at Ontimitta inspired Potana to compose Andhra Mahabhagavatam. Potana dedicated this to the Lord. Attirala is a corruption for Hatyarala. Hatya in Sanskrit means murder and Ralu in Telugu means fall off. It is the place where the sin of matricide was atoned. According to a legend, Parasurama finally cleansed off his blood-stained hands in the Bahuda river after killing his mother Renuka Devi. It is also known as Bhairavachala Kshetra or Parasurama Kshetra. Pushpagiri means the hill of flowers. It is the holiest place for both the Vaishnavites and Shaivites. Vaishnavites call it Madhya Hobilam and Shaivites call it Madhya Kailasam. Pushpagiri is the only place in the state where the holy peetam of Jagadguru Sri Adi Shankara was established. Sri Chennakeshava temple is known for beautiful sculptures. A special feature of Soumyanatha temple is that the idol of the Lord was installed in an elevated place and the Lord attracts the devotees with his glittering beauty and the devotees forget themselves in his presence. Sri Veerabhadra Swami temple at Raichoti was mentioned in all the Shaiva Puranas. The devotees from Karnataka and Maharashtra regularly visit this temple. Talapaka has the distinction of being the native place of Annamacharya, the saint composer of 15th and 16th centuries. He composed 32,000 Sankirtanas or devotional songs in praise of Lord Venkateshwara. Talapaka Timmakka, wife of Annamaya, was the first Telugu poetess who wrote Subhadra Kalyanam. Sri Krishna Devarayalu was one of the greatest of the Vijayanagara emperors. He was intimately connected with Kadapa district. He gave his third daughter Krishnamamba to Matli Varadaraja, a powerful prince of the Matli family. He gifted Kokatam village to Andhra Kavita Pitamaha Allasani Peddana. He also donated Tippaluru village to the Ashtadiggajas. Bhattumurthy, popularly known as Amraja Bhushana, was one of the Ashtadiggajas. He was a resident of Kasanuru village in Pulivendala Taluk. The poetess Kumara Molla wrote Molla Ramayana. She had a rare privilege of reciting Ramayana in Bhuvana Vijayam, the court of Krishnadevarayalu. Siddhavatam. Siddhavatam is said to have derived its name from Siddhas engaged in tapas or meditation under its vatams or banyan trees. It was held in considerable sanctity in the days gone by and even referred to as the southern gateway of Srisaila Kshetra and Dakshina Kasi. The fort was under the control of the Vijayanagara rulers, the Matli chiefs and the Mayana Nawabs of Kadapa. Gandikota derived its name from two Telugu words. Gandhi means George and Kota means fort. It is a Giridurga or a hill fort. It was an impregnable fort which offered stiff resistance to the enemies. Sri Madhavaraya temple at Gandikota was built by the Vijayanagara rulers. It has beautiful sculptures. Sri Potunur Veera Brahmam, popularly acclaimed as Indian Nostradamus, was a saint of the 17th century. He preached Advaita philosophy, Shiva Govinda Govinda, and said there is no difference between Shiva and Keshava. He attained Sajiva Samadhi in 1693. His Kalagnanam is preserved here. Amin Pir Darga, popularly known as Pedda Darga, was constructed in Kadapa in 1683 in memory of two Sufi saints, Pirullah Husseini and Arifullah Husseini. This Pedda Darga attracts people of various religions and cultures. It is believed that whoever makes a wish here gets it granted. Masjid in Gandikota. It is a beautiful masjid built by the Mayana Nawabs of Kadapa. Masjid-e-Azam Shahi Mosque Maidukur were the beautiful mosques built by the Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb. Sir Thomas Munro was the principal collector of the ceded districts from 1800s to 1807. During this period, he visited Gangaperuru. Lord Lakshmi Narasimha appeared before him and blessed him. Sir Thomas Munro became the governor of Madras Presidency from 1820 to 1827. Before leaving for England, he wanted to pay a farewell visit to ceded districts in May 1827. Munro came to Gandhi and saw the golden torana. Vayu, the father of Anjaneya, hung a golden torana, a wreath of golden flowers, and welcomed Rama in the earlier days. There is a belief among the people that this golden torana is visible to the sacred souls at the approach of their death. Munro's followers grieved much for this, for they knew that he would shortly die. In fact, Munro died on 6th July 1827 at Pathikonda due to cholera. He was buried at the European cemetery at the foot of the Guthi fort. The missionaries constructed beautiful churches for the benefit of the native Christians in Kadapa district. They are the Diocese of Kadapa, the Mariapuram Church, the Arogya Mata Punya Kshetram, and another church at Khajipeta. The Campbell Hospital at Jammalamadugu is one of the oldest hospitals in Kadapa district. It has been serving the poor and the needy since 1891. Jerdens coursers, locally known as Kalividi Kodi, is a rare species of birds found only in Kadapa district. It is an endangered bird. There is a temple of Lanka Malleshwara in the sanctuary. Wild dogs, panthers, cheetahs and sambars are also seen here. Gunjana waterfalls is the biggest waterfalls in AP. Gundala Kona, Nityapuja Kona, Panchalingala Kona and Veyinutala Kona are some of the places which are known for ecotourism. Gandikota Reservoir, Mailavaram Dam, Annamaya Project and Bugavanka Dam are the lifelines for the people of Kadapa district. They provide drinking and irrigation facilities. The Rayalaseema Thermal Power Plant at Muddano is a coal-based power project generating electricity. Vavilakolan Subbarao is popularly known as Andhra Valmiki. He wrote Ramayana in Telugu and dedicated it to Sri Kodandarama Swami at Ontimitta. Mahatma Gandhi visited Kadapa district in 1921, 1929 and 1933-34 during the freedom struggle. Kadapa Koti Reddy, a barrister, and his wife Ramasubbamma were the first couple from the district to join the national movement. Gajulapalle Veerabhadra Rao was another leader who actively participated in the freedom struggle. Durbhaka Rajashekara Sadavadhani was one of the foremost writers from Prudhuttur. He authored several books including Rana Pratapa Simha Charitra. Durbhaka Rajashekara Sadavadhani and Gadiyaram Venkatesesha Shastri together performed Avadhanams in the name of Rajashekara Venkatesesha Kavulu. In response to the call of Gandhiji, he resigned from government service. Gadiyaram Venkatesesha Shastri was a famous poet from Prudhuttur. He has 20 verses to his credit. Shivabharatam, written in 1943, was his masterpiece. Saraswati Putra, Puttaparthi Narayanacharyulu, was a multifaceted genius. He was one of the literary giants. Among his literary works, mention may be made of Shivatandavam and Penugonda Lakshmi. Shivatandavam is about the cosmic dance of Shiva. His wife, Puttaparthi Kanakamma, was also a great scholar. Puttaparthi happens to be one of the famous trio who put the town of Prudhuttur on the literary map of Andhra Pradesh, the other two being Durbhaka Rajashekara Sadavadhani and Gadiyaram Venkatesesha Shastri. B.N. Reddy was one of the veteran directors of Telugu film industry. He directed many films which won national and international recognition. Malleshwari, a film directed by him in 1951, is considered as a timeless Indian film classic. It is the first Telugu film to be screened at international film festivals. Rangularatnam, another film directed by Reddy in 1966, got National Filmfare Award for Best Feature Film in Telugu. He received Dada Saheb Phalke Award in 1976. B. Nagireddy set up Vijaya Vahini Studios in Madras, which was then Asia's biggest film studio. He was an ace producer and produced films in Telugu, Kannada and Hindi. His Telugu films include Patala Bhairavi, Missamma, Maya Bazaar and Gundamma Katha. He received several awards like Raghupati Venkaya Award in 1987, Kalai Mamani Award in 1972. He also received Dada Saheb Phalke Award in 1984. Basavaraju Venkata Padmanabha Rao, popularly known as Padmanabham, was known for his comedian roles. He hailed from Simhadripuram village in Pulivendula taluk of Kadapa district. He acted in more than 400 films. He was also a producer and director. The Municipal High School Kadapa was one of the oldest high schools in Kadapa district. It was established in 1857. C.P. Brown was the assistant collector of Kadapa in 1820. His bungalow was converted into a research library. It is affiliated to Yogi Vemana University. Sri Ramakrishna Matam Kadapa and is dedicated to the ideals of Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Originally, the Ramakrishna Matam was started in 1910 and was located in a building donated by Khan Bahadur Manju Mia, a Sufi follower. The All India Radio Kadapa was established in 1963. History of Rayalaseema in general and Kadapa district in particular was recorded here by inviting historians, writers, artists and scholars from various walks of life. A unique contribution of Kadapa district to the theater performance is Surabhi, a well-known theater group. This 125-year-old family-based theater was founded by V. Sanjeeva Rao in 1889. It became popular under Govinda Rao. Archaeological museum was established in 1982 with donations from the Jain community. It is a storehouse of antiquities dating back to the period between 5th and 18th century. The glory of Kadapa district is presented in a nutshell. There are many historical monuments and personalities who and which deserve attention by all of us. Thank you.